Welcome the students of SC Civil for the subject surveying, unit number 4, curves. For this we will use the reference book Kanirkal Kulkarni Surveying Leveling, Duggal Surveying, Kunmiya Higher Surveying, Subramanyam Surveying and Leveling, Basak Surveying and Leveling, Das and Das Surveying. Now we will see the course outcomes. On successful completion of this course, student will be able to define and explain basics of plane surveying and differentiate the instruments used for it. Second course outcome, express proficiency in handling surveying equipment and analyze the surveying data from this equipment. Third course outcome, describe different methods of surveying and find relative positions of points on the surface of the earth. Fourth course outcome, execute curve setting for civil engineering projects such as roads, railways, etc. Fifth course outcome, articulate advancements in surveying such as space-based positioning systems. Sixth course outcome, differentiate map and aerial photographs, also interpret aerial photographs. Now we will see the course objectives. With the successful completion of the course, the student should have the capability to describe the function of surveying in civil engineering construction. Second course objective, identify the sources of measurement errors and mistake. Understand the difference between accuracy and precision as it relates to distance, differential leveling and angular measurements. Third course objective, identify and calculate the errors in measurement and to develop corrected values of differential level circuits, horizontal distances and angles for open or closed loop traverse. Fourth course objective, effectively communicate with team members during field activities, identify appropriate safety procedures for personal protection, properly handle and use measurement instruments. Fifth course objective is be able to identify hazardous environments and take measures to ensure one's personal and team safety. Sixth course objective, perform traverse calculation, determine latitude, departures and coordinates of control points and balancing errors in a traverse. Use appropriate software for calculations and plotting. Seventh course objective is operate a total station to measure distance, angles and to calculate difference in elevation. Reduce data for application in a geographic information system. Eighth course objective is work as a team member on a surveying party to achieve a common goal of accurate and timely project completion. And ninth course objective is calculate, design and establish curves, understand, interpret and prepare plan, profile and cross-section drawings. Work with cross-sections and topographic maps to calculate areas, volumes and earthwork quantities. So this is the unit number 4, curves syllabus, which include introduction to horizontal and vertical curves, including numericals but derivations not expected, different types of curves and their applications, simple and compound circular curves, elements and setting out by linear methods such as radial and perpendicular offset, offset from long chord, successive bisection of chord and offsets from chords produced, angular methods, Rankine method of deflection angles, 1 and 2 theodolite methods, numerical on simple circular curves and compound curves to be asked, transition curves necessity. Now we will see the offsets from long chord, successive bisection of chord, offsets from tangent and offsets from chord produce. First we will see offsets from long chord. So this is the figure which shows the curve setting. This is the curve. It has to be set by offsets or coordinates from long chord. So T1, E, T2, this is the long chord. So let AB, this AB and BC, the tangents of the curve. That is T1, D, T2, this is the curve. T1 and T2, this T1 point and this T2 point is equal to, we can consider as the tangent points. Then T1, T2, that is the long chord of length capital L. So this is capital L. Then ED, this distance, vertical distance, ED is equal to, we can consider as O0. That is the offset at mid point of T1, T2, that is also called as the Versaid sign. Then PQ, this PQ, we can consider this as OX, that is equal to offset at any distance X. So this any distance X from capital E, so that EP is equal to X. This arbitrary value we can consider as X. OT1 is equal to OT2 is equal to OD, that is equal to R, that is the radius of the curve. The exact formula for the offsets at any point on the long chord is as follows. Draw QQ1 parallel to T1, T2, meeting ED, this ED at Q1. Join OQ, cutting T1, T2, this line, cutting T1, T2 in P1, this P1 point. Now in the triangle, OT1E, OT1 is equal to R, that is the radius. T1E, that is the L by 2, this length of long chord is L, so it is L by 2. Then OE is equal to OD, this full length OD minus this small distance ED. So OD value is R minus ED value is O0, so it is R minus O0. Therefore OT1 square is equal to T1E square plus OE square. Therefore OT1 value we can write it as R, so it is as R. T1E we can write it as L by 2 square, and OE, so OE value we can consider it from here, R minus O0. So total R minus O0 is the OE, so square of that. So by solving this example, this equation, we can get O0 is equal to R minus under root R square minus L by 2 square. Stop. Start. Of the three quantities O0, L and R, two quantities L and R or L and O0 are usually known. The remaining unknown may be calculated from the previous formula. Now from the triangle OQQ1, so OQQ1, this triangle we have to consider, OQQ1, OQ square is equal to QQ1 square plus OQ1 square, but QQ1 is equal to OE plus EQ1. So QQ1, so but QQ1 is equal to OE plus EQ1, that is equal to OE plus OX, that is equal to OE value we can write it as R minus O0 plus OX. Therefore QQ1 is equal to X, So QQ1 is equal to X and OQ, that is the R, that is the radius. Therefore, R square is equal to X square plus R minus O0 plus OX square. So solving this equation, we get OX is equal to OX plus R minus O0 is equal to R under root R square minus X square. Therefore, OX is equal to under root R square minus X square minus R minus O0. This is the exact formula to find out the OX, this PQ distance, any distance. When the radius of the curve is large as compared with the length of the chord, the offsets may be calculated from the approximate formula. In this case PQ, the offset OX at P is very nearly equal to the radial ordinate QP1, then QP1 multiplied by twice R is equal to T1P multiplied by PT2. Now T1P is equal to X, T1T2 is L, therefore PT2 is equal to L minus X and QP1 is equal to OX, therefore OX is equal to X in bracket L minus X bracket complete upon twice R. This is the approximate formula. It must be remembered that in the first case, the distance of the point P is measured from the midpoint of the long chord, while in the second case, it is measured from the first tangent point T1. To set out the curve for the offsets from long chord, first step is to divide the long chord into an equal number of equal parts, and second is set out the offset as calculated from exact formula at each of the points of divisions, thus obtaining the required points on the curve. Since the curve is symmetrical along ED, the offsets for the right half of the curve may be the same as those for the left half. If the offsets are calculated from approximate formula, the long chord should be divided into a convenient number of equal parts and the calculated offset set out at each of the points of division. This method is usually used for setting out short curves, example curves for street curves, when the offset from the long chord, that is T1, T2, are too long to be set out with sufficient accuracy. The curve may be set out from the chords T1D and DT2 after the point D is located by the calculated offsets ED. The length of T1D and DT2 are now each equal to twice R sine 5 by 4. The rest of the procedure is the same as before. So we have seen the offsets from long chord. Now we will see the successive bisection of chord. So here this is the curve setting by successive bisections of arcs. So this is the long chord T1, T2 and this is the bisection of the arcs. So this is the T1, D, T2. So this is the curve. Let T1 and T2 be the tangent points. Join T1, T2 and bisect it at AE. Set out the offset ED, that is Versailles sine, that is equal to R1 minus cos 5 by 2, thus determining the point D on the curve. Join T1D and DT2 and bisect them at F and G respectively. At F and G, set out the offset FH and GH each equal to R1 minus cos 5 by 4, thus obtaining two more points H and K on the curve. By repeating the above process, set out as many points as required. So we have seen the successive bisections of chord. Now we will see the offsets from tangents. So here we can see the figure curve setting by offsets from tangent. This is radial offsets. Another is the perpendicular offset. So first we will see the radial offset. In this method, offsets from tangent, in this method the offsets are set out either radially or perpendicular to the tangents BA and BC. Accordingly, according as the center O of the curve is accessible or inaccessible. So first we will see by radial offset. Let T1 is equal to first tangent point, then EE1 is equal to OX, that is the radial offset at E at a distance X from the T1 along the tangent AB. So this we can consider as X. Now in the triangle OT1E, this triangle we have to consider. OT1 is equal to R, that is the radius. T1E, that is X. OE is equal to this. OE is equal to OE1 plus E1E, that is equal to R plus OX. So this is R plus OX. Now OE square is equal to OT1 square minus T1E square. Therefore R plus OX square is equal to R square plus X square. So solving this equation we get OX is equal to under root R square plus X square minus R. This is the exact formula. When the radius is large, the offset may be calculated by the approximate formula. So ET1 square. So ET1 square is equal to EE1 multiplied by twice R plus EE1. That is X square is equal to OX, this OX, plus twice R minus OX. Since OX square is very small as compared with twice R, it may be neglected. Therefore, OX is equal to X square upon twice R. This is the approximate formula for radial offset. Expanding the factor under root R square plus X square, we have OX is equal to R in bracket 1 plus X square upon twice R square minus X raised to 4 upon 8 R square plus, like that it will be increasing, and outside the bracket minus R. Neglecting the other terms except the first two, we get OX is equal to R 1 plus X square upon twice R square minus R. Therefore OX is equal to X square upon twice R. This is the approximate formula to find out the radial offset. Now this is the figure showing curve setting by offset from tangent the perpendicular offset. So here we can see the perpendicular offset. Offsets from tangents we are seeing. In this method the offsets are set out either radially or perpendicular to the tangents BA and BC according as the center O of the curve is accessible or inaccessible. Now we will see the second by perpendicular offset. Let E1E be the perpendicular offset at the distance X measured along the tangent line AB from the tangent point T1, so that T1E is equal to X. Through E1, draw E1, E2 parallel to BT1 meeting at OT1 at E2. Then E1, E2 is equal to T1E is equal to X. T1E2 is equal to EE1 is equal to OX. Now OE2 is equal to OT1 minus T1E2, that is equal to R minus OX. Now from the triangle OE1E2, now this small triangle we have to consider. OE1 square is equal to E1E2 square plus OE2 square, that is R square is equal to X square plus R minus OX square, or OX is equal to R minus under root R square minus X square. This is the exact formula to find out the offset by perpendicular offset. from which the corresponding approximate formula may be obtained by expanding the factor under root r square minus x square. Thus, we have expanding the factor under root r square minus x square, we have Ox is equal to r minus r in bracket 1 minus x square upon twice r square minus x raised to 4 upon 8 r square minus it will be increasing. Neglecting the higher powers of r square, we get Ox is equal to r minus r in bracket 1 minus x square upon twice r square. Therefore, Ox is equal to x square upon twice r. This is approximate formula. The method was formerly in common use for railway curves. So, we have seen the offsets from tangents. Now, we will see the offsets from chords produced. So, this is the figure showing curve setting by offsets from chord produced. So, these are the chords which are produced. Let AB, this AB, the rear tangent, and T1 the first tangent point, then EFG, this EFG, etc., the successive points on the curve, T1, E1 is equal to T1, E, the first chord of length B1. So, this is the length of B1. EF, this EF, FG, etc. is equal to successive chords of length B2, B3, etc. each being equal of the length of unit chord. Then BT1E, then BT1E is equal to alpha in radian, that is the angle between the tangent BT1 and the first chord T1E. E1E, E1E is equal to O1, that is the offset from tangent BT1. So, this is the BT1 offset. E2F, E2F is equal to O2, that is equal to offset from the preceding chord T1E. So, T1E, this is the preceding chord T1E produced. Draw the tangent DEF1. DEF1 at E, meeting the rear tangent at D, meeting the rear tangent at D, produce T1E, produce T1E to E2, continue to E2, so that E, E2 is equal to B2. Let F1 be the point of intersection of D, E, F1 and E2, F. The formula for the offset may be deduced as follows. The angle subtended at the center O of the curve by the arc T1E, that this is T1E, is obviously equal to twice alpha, this twice alpha. But the chord T1E, this T1E chord, is equal to the arc T1E, this is the arc T1E, very nearly equal to R multiplied by twice alpha, or we can say alpha is equal to T1E upon twice R. Similarly, the chords E1E, E1E is equal to arc E1E nearly. Therefore, first offset O1, this first offset O1 is equal to E1E is equal to T1E multiplied by alpha. Therefore, T1E square upon twice R, that is equal to B1 square upon twice R. Now, the angle E2EF1, E2EF1, this angle we have to consider, is equal to DET1, DET1, that is vertically opposite. Therefore, the angle DET1, DET1 is equal to DT1E, DT1E, since dt1 is equal to dE, both being tangents to the circle. Therefore, E2 EF1, E2 EF1 is equal to angle dT1E is equal to angle E1T1E. The triangles E1T1E and E2EF1 being nearly isosceles may be considered approximately similar. Therefore, E2F1 upon EE2 is equal to E1E upon T1E, that is E2F1 upon B2 is equal to O1 upon B1, or we can consider E2F1 is equal to B2 multiplied by O1 upon B1 is equal to, we can consider as B2 multiplied by B1 square upon B1 and twice R, that is equal to B2 B1 upon twice R. F1 F, so this F1 F being the offset from the tangent at E, therefore E F square upon twice R is equal to B2 square upon twice R. Now the second offset O2, that is equal to E2F, this offset is equal to E2F1 plus F1F, that is equal to B2 B1 upon twice R plus B2 square upon twice R, that is equal to B2 in bracket B1 plus B2 bracket complete upon twice R. Similarly, the third offset O3, that is equal to B3 in bracket B2 plus B3 upon twice R is equal to B3 square upon R. Since B2 is equal to B3 is equal to B4 is equal to B5, etc., each of the successive offsets O4, O5 except the last one On is equal to O3 only. So this O3 offset, since the length of the last chord is usually less than the length of the unit chord B2, last offset On is equal to Bn in bracket Bn minus 1 plus Bn bracket complete upon twice R. So we have seen the offsets from chord produced. So we have seen the offsets from long chord, successive bisection of chord, offsets from tangents, and offsets from chord produce. So these are the YouTube links available on the YouTube 05 curve ESE derived method by offsets or ordinates from long chord, 06 curves problem 01 related to offsets or ordinate from long chord, curve part 4 setting out of curve by linear method, curve part 5 numerical on setting out of curve by offset from long chord linear method, setting out of curve by offset from long chord method, setting out curve by offset from long chord, curves long chord method. Next YouTube link, curve setting out by successive bisection of arc, setting out of linear curve successive bisection of chord arc serving, setting out of curve using linear methods by successive bisection of arcs part 3, curve lecture 5 setting out curve by successive bisection of arc chord simple circular curve, setting out of simple curve by offsets from the chord produced part 5 Hindi curves in serving, method of offset from chord produced part 1, setting out of simple curve by offset from the chord produced problem part 6 Hindi. Next YouTube link, numerical on horizontal curve by offsets from chord produce method, serving two curve lecture 4b, problem on locating curve by offset from chord produce, offset from chords produce. So we have seen offsets from long chord, successive bisection of chord, offsets from tangent, offsets from chords produce. So this is the syllabus of unit number 4 curves, introduction to horizontal and vertical curves, including numericals but derivation not expected, different types of curves and their applications, simple and compound circular curves, elements and setting out by linear methods such as radial and perpendicular offset, offsets from long chord, successive bisection of chord and offsets from chord produce, angular methods, Rankine method of deflection angle, 1 and 2 theodolite methods, numerical on simple circular curve and compound curve to be asked, transition curves necessity. Thank you all. students,